G'day guys, I'm the one and only STROM, and I'd like to know, how yous doing? Good? Oh well, that's great. So, for Christmas this year, I decided I'd come up to my cousin Melissa's place. And Melissa had the idea of giving me a makeover. So, without further ado, meet my cousin Melissa. That's your cue.
Hi.
She's going to be the one giving me the makeover, and she's in complete creative control of my face. I may regret this, but then again, I may not. So, without further babbling on and stalling for time, let's get started.
Okay. So, I thought I'd start with the eyebrows. Now this is...
Leaning in.
Okay.
Don't feel much just yet.
Very bushy.
Well, I'm a guy. What do you expect? I can feel it, but there's... I don't think there's much difference.
This is gonna take a while.
I know. Eyebrow now, or no?
Well, they're just so hairy. I don't know what to do, if I should really thin them out, but we need some wax or something to do that.
What do you say we just, like, you do the same thing you just done with the other eyebrow and then just leave it at that? Mm. My eyebrows are too bushy to, you know, change too much.
If we had wax.
I'm kind of glad you don't have wax. I'm watching them bloody tweezers.
Okay, that's sort of... That's okay. They're still very bushy, so we'll pretend they're...
We'll pretend they're not. Okay, what's next?
This is just some moisturiser, face cream.
Alrighty. It's nothing too drastic just yet. And what's this supposed to do?
Keep the voluptuous, youthful look.
Well, the only reason I'm asking these questions, just so you know, is because I know virtually nothing about makeup, so...
Okay. So, then I'm going to put on some concealer.
Here's where the transformation really starts.
This is magic.
What are you folding it down like that for?
I just see how it was a bit gloppy.
Oh yeah, I see what you're doing with it. Okay. You're spreading it down over the little sponge.
Yeah. So, close your eyes. And just sort of dab it on first and then go over it. Mostly around the eyes. Even out any imperfections. I find it really covers up things, this one. You know, the not so nice-ies.
Thanks for speaking nicely of my face.
Mm. we go the BB cream or the foundation. Might need a bit of that.
What are you trying to say? I have bad skin? Do I have to close my eyes?
Not just yet.
Are you sure you don't know what you're doing?
Well, I'm not a professional, but I do put my own makeup on. So.
I'm thinking you'd have experience with it.
More than you.
Well, I'm not even sure how this is supposed to feel when you're like applying the makeup, so.
My mum calls makeup panel beating.
I can see why.
Yeah. Okay. So there's our base. Fresh canvas to work with.
Okay.
With no drink.
I feel a difference in my face.
Yeah.
I definitely feel it's on there.
Does it feel a bit moist? Because I find with that BB cream, it just it does a bit, so you can just.
I wasn't gonna feel moist at all, actually.
No. Okay. So now.
Now it gets interesting.
It does. Now I might do some eyeshadow.
Now here's where we'll see the real difference, depending on their choice of colour.
Okay. Keep your eyes closed.
Okay.
Okay. I thought I might do
can
a little...
Can I open my eyes or no?
Yeah, you can open them now. Thought I might do like a smoky eye. Well, attempt it.
I'm just trying to see what colour you've laid on my eyes.
Well, that was just a cream colour.
Ah, okay.
Just to be like, to make it a bit blank. Okay, so now we're hitting the hard shapes. Okay.
Just tell me what to do.
Close your eyes.
That feels weird. But what you're doing right now, it feels really weird.
Open it. Okay, I'm just gonna. Don't tense your eye.
I dread to think what I'm going to see when I finally do open my eyes. Oh, I'm still too. Camera squeezed just a little too small for me to see. I can't see the full results yet, so. Relax. I am relaxing. My eyes just, you know, eyelids just naturally flicker when you do that.
Now, do you want any colour?
Yeah, why not?
What colour?
A bright colour.
Like green?
Yeah, why not? We'll go green. So I gotta have to close my eyes?
Mm-hmm. Some of this on over just to blend it in a bit better so it's not so dark, you know.
Oh yeah.
Sometimes too dark can just look a bit too much. Okay, so now this is the bit that you're really gonna have to trust me with. Eyeliner.
It seems a lot of this makeup making stuff is focused mainly
around the eyes. The eyes, definitely, because, you know, to emphasize the eye, I think, is beautiful. Yeah, I do. It is a lot based around the eyes.
I still can't see my face on the little screen, but, you know, doesn't matter. Okay. Go for it.
So, open your eye. This is what I mean about close to me.
Oh, shit.
Mm-hmm.
You might have to hold
Shut
one.
Up. I find when other people do this to me, it tickles. Yeah, I can't handle it.
You might actually have to hold my eyelids open.
No, that's fine, that's fine.
My eyelids.
Okay, now the mascara.
Ah, so now we're going to give me the nice, luscious lashes.
Okay. If you actually do have nice lashes, any woman would kill for these.
Really?
Yeah. They're really long and thick.
I never realised that. Then again, what do I pay attention to my face for?
Women pay for these. Like with eyelash extensions and stuff like that.
I seriously do not understand. Like, why would you want to have long lashes? I feel it now.
Because it looks pretty.
Yeah, but your eyelashes feel heavy. Okay, do women complain about that?
No, not as long as they've got long lashes, they're happy. So basically now, what I will do is I put a bit of powder over the face just for a more even complexion. This one's a little bit darker, so I put two on. I put this one and a light one on. Okay, so then this is the light one.
I wonder how I'll look.
Smashing!
I'll take your word for it for now. But if I don't look smashing at the end of this, you're fired.
So this is sort of your cheeks. Put a bit of colour in there. A little rosy cheek. And so, lipsticks. This one's quite red.
This
I don't know how you feel about that.
I don't mind. Like I said, you have complete creative
So I
control.
Learned this little trick when I was in high school. I read it in a magazine. If you do a little dot at the top of your lip here and then in where it dips down, you know, one there and then one there and then sort of join them together with a line, that's how you get a nice shape on your lip.
Doesn't feel like you got over here.
What do you mean?
Like, this little part of my...
Look, you just made me mess it up. I'm a big fan of, because I haven't got great makeup, so I mix my colours. So that was like a deep red, and now with this one over the top, it's got like a light glitter look to it as well. Do you know what I mean?
I have to see it in the mirror first.
That's the bit that you made me mess up.
My bad.
So. So, I've done pretty good at the smoky eye look. Show me. Show me how you look.
Yeah. I can kind of see it from here now, and it looks very, yeah.
Do you want me to get a mirror?
Yeah, actually, please do. Holy fuck! Holy fuck, I didn't think I looked that bloody different. Jeez. I look like I'm actually related to one of my aunties.
So did you like it?
It's certainly,
different.
Yeah. No, makeover isn't finished yet.
So, yeah, do you want me to do your hair?
Yep, that's the last part, isn't it?
Yeah, well, I've just got to let this heat up.
Yeah, just hit the end record button while that's heating up. I was just like, don't burn my scalp.
Spraying?
Thank you. can honestly say I'm not comfortable with that thing's that hot thing near so near my neck. I'm keeping very still so I don't really bump the fucking thing.
Accidents like that happen every day.
They're not gonna happen to me.
I wish I had hair like yours.
Yeah, it requires maintenance. Although being a guy, I only bloody just brush it and bloody, you know, wash it in the shower with shampoo and conditioner.
Yeah, it takes longer than you actually think too. You know how you said, oh, it's the same length as mine? It's like down to there, the longest point of it.
Yeah, I know that. So just most of the time it just doesn't feel all that long. Because I'm so used to it, haven't I? So. Yeah, this is the part I hate.
I think we've all burned out at the tips of our ears, at least once. Women, I mean.
Yeah, well. Okay. Are you done with that section?
Yeah.
So you're moving on to which section? Ah, that one.
The next one.
I'm just wondering, why did you tie that section back up for?
Because to make it a bit higher so I can access this one a bit better, easier. Is that alright?
Yeah, I suppose. I mean, you're the one who knows what you're doing here.
Kind of. Well, I've got an idea.
Oh, that's reassuring. My hair is food. What next? Oh, by the way, in case you haven't realised, me and Melissa are both drunk, so, you know.
Speak for yourself. I've only had 3 cans.
What can I say? You must be a light drunk. I'm watching you on the mini screen, watching you move around. I'm trying to figure out which section of hair you're doing.
It's got so much of it.
I know. My hair's always been thick. Regardless of whether I have it long or short.
Thank you. Is this your hair's natural colour?
No. Can't you tell it's dyed red?
Yeah, I can see like a red tinge in it. I didn't know if it was dyed or naturally. Like, I was going to say, wow, it's got like this pretty red for it.
Definitely not natural. Honestly, see, can't see too much of a difference in my hair. Aside from my hair just being a little bit springy.
That next bit.
If that's your mum, whose are the kids?
Shh. Must be friends of the people at the back because they got a boy kid. There's a girl kid. She's gonna go like, what the heck is this girl?
I can just imagine. It'll probably happen any minute now.
You know what I heard her say? I don't start till late tomorrow, so I think she's talking about having a drink. She'll be like, I don't start till late tomorrow, so I'm going to get smashed. No, she wouldn't say smashed, but she'd say, I'm going to have
a drink. We'll soon find out what she'll say.
So pretty,
like,
I reckon, personally.
Like I said, I'm yet to see the end results.
Yeah. Hi, Mom.
Hi. So how are you doing?
What does it look like? I'm getting a makeover. Careful, but it's on camera. That's my Aunty Julie, by the way.
Say hi, Mum.
Hi.
We'll be on YouTube. YouTube sensation.
What do you think?
Look at Jacko, I reckon.
Yeah, but what about his hair and that? Do you reckon
it
looks
nice? You make a good woman.
His hair is beautiful.
Yeah.
He's got the best lashes as well. Like the eyelashes, they're like about that long.
Is that what you got for Christmas?
No, he's had it for a while. Mum?
Fucking hell, I don't... Listen, be silent.
It is your mum's house after all, Melissa.
Yes. Yeah, time to crack a good one.
I see where you cut your hair yourself, Andrew. Now, you should see how short this bit is compared to...
I might give this tawny pot a sample, see what it's going to be like for the trifle, and then I'll have...
Andrew's going home tomorrow because Warren's coming down.
Are you? Oh, I thought you were staying for Christmas Day.
Yeah, but his dad's coming down.
Yeah, change of plans.
Well, about time he bloody well done something. Because I didn't know what was going on with him.
You know, my dad's busy a lot of the time, so it's understandable for me.
Oh, yeah, that's a good drop.
Ugh, no.
Tawny.
Port.
It's tawny.
She's an old wino.
You're going lovely in the trifle. So you're going up your dad's?
No, he's coming down to visit me in my new home.
Okay.
Because this will be the first time he's seen it. So
you were going out for lunch and that, or something? Oh, he's coming down tomorrow?
No. From what I've heard, it's supposed to be either bloody Christmas Day, Boxing Day, or the day after. So I just wonder, are you ready? Because, you know, I don't want my dad to have to, like, you know, waste petrol coming up here. Or coming up to Wollongong. So.
Well, just give him a ring and ask him what day he's coming down. That way you can... you'll know.
My phone's been playing up, Aunty Julie. I can't... Half the numbers are what...
You can see my phone if you want.
Oh, don't worry. I've already talked to my brother about it, so... Got it all sorted out, so don't need to worry about it.
Should greet your dad at the door like this.
Change it
now.
Yeah, I can buy another one. That'll just be something to have for supper.
How much was that?
$12.
Oh, that's alright. Can change it for another 4 bottles. Well,
I tried ringing it, but your phone was off. Jack Daniels, $35.
Where from?
For a 700ml bottle.
Yeah, I saw that, but they didn't have the 2 for $70.
$35 though.
Did you get one?
Compared to the other one, which was $42. That's the white one, but still, it doesn't matter. And then you got the black one was, the other one was 68. God knows why. It's all Jack Daniels.
The black one was 68.
Yeah, it'll all get you fucking tippled.
I'm just letting her do a thing.
This is how he'll remember me when I go. He'll be like, oh, remember that time when I sit on my makeover?
Yeah, well, Andrew will let you be a practice hairdresser, won't he? He loves it.
This is a one-time only deal. This is not going to be one of those recurring things, Aunty Julie.
Isn't it? Say that now.
Well, not yet anyway. Depends on the final result.
Do we get to pluck your eyebrows?
I was going to, but they are so hairy, Mum. We need to get the wax out, heat it up on the oven or something.
Mm. No, we're not going bush pig soul with the body wax.
We'll take you from bush pig to beauty.
I'm fine with my eyebrows the way they are.
Don't worry, darling. There are a lot of men that groom their brows.
Yeah, I'm not one of them.
There's no need nothing to be ashamed of, my love.
Well, you don't
I'm not ashamed of it. I'm just...
Guy Sebastian.
I just don't wax my eyebrows.
He grooms his eyebrows, and he used to have ones a bit like yours. You know, when we first met him many years ago on Australia Idol. Yes.
Might come be alcoholic for the fucking Christmas period, I think. Well, it's got a good fucking aftertaste to it, to that tawny shit. It's nice and creamy. Now, got a drop of the fucking heavy suit. What?
You watch, you'll be putting up all these and Mum will come an internet sensation. YouTube sensation from the background.
The quotes of my Aunty Julie.
Now, I reckon. Do you reckon I'll have anything left by Christmas? I might have to buy another one tomorrow.
Well, no, you're not drinking too heavily, right?
I have to start working until fucking 3 tomorrow.
You're not drinking too heavily right now, so I think you're fine.
We might go to the pub later
then. I should drink until the fucking cows come on.
Mum.
I've got all day to sleep it off. Whew. That's a nice fucking... That's a nip, isn't it?
Yeah.
More?
No. Start off...
Oh, fuck you, you're just trying to keep me straight.
No, I'm not. I would prefer you drunk, trust me.
That's saying a lot.
I've got to do my hair yet. Well, you don't do my fucking hair when I need it blonding.
help you.
Right after me.
My feet have been aching like a motherfucker. I was so glad I got a fucking lift home today. Because I wouldn't have been home until after 5:30.
You haven't noticed anything different under the tree?
Yeah, there's a motherfucking big present there. I'd like to know what it is and whose is it.
It's yours.
I know what it is.
Is it that lizard?
No, I'm telling you what it is, Mum. What lizard?
Well, it's in a box, so it can't be the lizard.
Let me just say, Aunty Julie, with your first guess, you're way off.
And don't even give her any hints.
Oh, Andrew drops hints all the time. All I have to do is loosen his tongue with that and I'll be right.
That is if Melissa doesn't staple my mouth shut first.
You want a drink, Andrew?
I've got my own goon.
Oh, wouldn't you rather some Jack?
No, I don't care. What a drink. On, what I drink. Jack. Well, if you're going to give me one, this is my cup here.
Well, what's that?
That's the goon.
Well, drink that down first. You've already spilled alcohol all over the table and the true alcohol and stuff.
Excuse me, you did that.
It was already there when I came in.
Yeah, you knocked it over. Don't go blaming me for things you done.
Good lick of
fucking Jack
in there. Good lick. Good lick of Jack. Well, there's no one
to fucking box here. It's got to be fucking Andrew's getting excited.
Strong enough to bring some hairs on your chest. Well, there's no point in fucking drinking it.
Everyone, this is what life is like with my relatives.
That's why he's going
Christmas
tomorrow.
Once again, his dad's not really coming. Until next Christmas.
He hasn't even got it back.
Tis the season to be jolly. Let's get jolly and let's
have a good lick of Jack.
Yeah, right. Well, a lick of Jack would be better than a lick of Molly. Yeah, I think it goes with jolly.
These are the times where I just don't even try to resist what they say. I just go with it.
Did you get colour in your hair as well?
I've had the colour in my hair for a while.
Look how pretty it looks, Mum. Should see it at the back. It looks natural. It looks like you're a beach person. You know what I mean? Like beach hair.
Oh, you have them chasing you like crazy with your hair like that, Andrew. You need to get one of these hair curlers.
No, he would not be able to do this by himself. He's got the thickest hair I've ever seen.
The man would be saying, who's that fucking lass? I want him.
I highly doubt it.
Bunch of
I probably burnt my hair off trying to do it myself.
Believe me, I burnt my neck on that thing. I look like I had a full
I probably burnt my neck a few hundred times as well.
You should have seen it. It looked like she had a hickey. It was a big burn.
I'd be no good at using a hair straightener or a hair curler or any of these hair things.
You
myself,
just get used
solo.
To it.
I'd rather have someone do it for me.
Yeah, I was stoked when you weren't here when I got home so I could wrap that without you seeing what it was.
How did you get it in? When did you buy it?
Today.
Oh.
And she got it in through the front door.
Well, let's
not
that
big.
Axel doesn't rip it open for you.
Aunty Julie, it's not that big.
It's just a fucking box and it's big. It's probably just a cardboard box with anything in it.
I know what's inside it. A stone.
A brick.
It's probably heavy. I must give it a test.
No, you just leave it alone.
Why?
Because I said
it'll make a lot of noise.
Same rule applies to me, Aunty Julie. Melissa would not let me touch the gift she got me, or that you and her and your family got me, so fair's fair.
Well, I think you should give your dad a ring, so that way you'll know if he's not going to be down on Christmas Day.
No.
Then you'll be getting tiffled with us.
Yeah, well, I would like to do that, but my phone has been blowing up, and I don't even have his number with me.
Oh, well, ring Alex.
No, he wants to go back so he's there for his dad. His dad's going to come Christmas, I know it. He said he would.
I don't know. Well, either way, whether he turns up or not, I won't hold it against him because my dad, from what he's told me, he doesn't know his way around Wollongong very well, so. Or the Illawarra in general. You know, he knows it basically from what he's told me, but, you know, he's just never had the best.
Well, you'll ring Alex on my phone and get him to find out.
Aunty Julie,
Christmas, no Christmas dinner. That way you know when he's going to.
Aunty Julie, enough.
If he wants to stay, he'll stay. I'm just doing the top bit in heaps smaller segments so that it really puffs it out, you know what I mean? Like a lot of curls up the top.
Okay.
So it might take a little bit longer. Break it down. And see, like, the thinner the pieces I do it in, the wavier it makes it.
I did not know that.
No, I just sort of noticed that myself.
And how long have you been doing this for?
I looked at my hair a few times. Like, I've got naturally curly hair, I don't need to do it. Do I, really?
Suppose not.
I don't know. Ring him and ask. Mum?
Ask my Aunty Julie.
She has it now. She has a vocabulary like a well-educated sailor.
That's one way of putting it.
You need to listen to your vocabulary then sometimes too.
Oh, I wonder where I get it.
Well, you're 35. You've had plenty of time to change it if it bothers you.
No. Be offended.
Well, at 35 you make your own decisions as to how you talk.
It's been conditioned into me since I was a baby. You know what my first word was?
No, don't use someone else's excuse.
I remember when Cassandra was just a little baby, I've got a memory. Here's a memory. Remember we're talking about memories?
Yeah.
She was sitting on Daddy's lap and she was probably about, maybe about 12 months old, maybe a little bit older. And she had a cold milk. Dave was feeding her. Well, she was sitting with Dave. She was feeding herself. Anyway, she spilt some down the front of her. She just had nappy on. And she said, fuck.
As her first word?
No, not as her first word, but she said it, clear as day, at the perfect timing. Like, the spilt down her and she went, fuck. Remember, Mum? And it was just so cute. We couldn't even, like, be like, no, that's naughty. We were just like...
She was like, oh, how cute.
We were laughing. And now, it's one of her favourite words.
I think it's everyone's favourite word. Well, in our family anyway. And I'll use it quite a lot.
Is Sandra coming up for Christmas, Mum?
She's working.
Yeah, but is she going to come up the next day or something? Or?
She's working Boxing Day as well.
Mm. She works hard. Macca's never shuts down.
Well, I'm trying to get me to get these fucking...
The fast food that never sleeps. Mum! You can't turn it up while we're filming.
Why?
Because it will drown out the sound and that.
We had it down for a reason. Well, it is Aunty Julie's house, so...
Look how pretty it looks.
Have you actually done this little fringe part that you've left dangling?
I'm going to do it now.
Because I've been wondering.
I can't get over how awesome it looks like from the back in that. Make sure you show everyone the back when it's done.
Well, you've had a front row seat to the back of my hair.
So if we pluck your eyebrows, we can take it and publicly shut them out. You can pass as a woman.
Yeah, in order for me to pass as a woman, you'd also have to wax my arms and legs. And that is not happening.
Ah, we'll just put pants on. You haven't got fucking legs in a woman.
Well, I've always known that.
Well, maybe if they weren't hairy, they would be, alright.
Please help me.
A very athletic woman, you know?
Please kill me.
Oh, Axel.
Right, now I can see the curls. Now I know what you mean by it. Oh, that part's a bit done.
It's about all the hair I've got on my whole head.
I can't help. So are you done or?
No. Yeah, a normal person's hair we would be, but
I keep on forgetting this is my thick hair, so.
Yes. You could grow this and I swear to God shave it off and sell it. It's really nice hair. Good people make hair extensions out of it, you know what I mean?
Yeah. I suppose.
They get them weaved into their hair. Like, it's true, that's real. Women pay up to $1,000 or more to get human hair weaved into their hair.
I'm not going to shave my hair.
Yeah, that's
sell for money.
Thank you. Alright, not long now. About three more crimps.
When you say three more crimps?
The straight bit hanging down his shoulder on his dog's viewer.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, I think because I made them too thick, the vouchers of hair.
Well, if you want to rebuild, rebuild. I'm not stopping you.
Perfect. Looks nice, eh, Mum? So Pauline got her eyelashes done?
She's waiting for me to come down.
Oh, cool.
I don't know if I'm keen to get them done or not though.
Oh, I will. Alright, it's done.
Oh, Andrew. Just give it a little shake. There's this few little strands of hair that just fell down into annoying poses on my face.
That looks amazing.
Oh, yeah. I see. I look like a nice, almost woman. Well, anyway, that's it for this vlog, so yeah. See you later.
Bye.